Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. This video describes the discovery of Nivasorexant, a selective orexin-1 receptor antagonist for the treatment of certain behavioral disorders. The video reports the discovery program of Nivasorexant as described in a Drug Annotation article in the Journal of Medicinal Chemistry by scientists at Idorsia Pharmaceuticals in Allschwil, Switzerland. The citation is at the bottom of the screen, and a link to the article can be found in the video description. This video does not cover all aspects of the article, as I have selected the parts most relevant to the medicinal chemistry classes I teach. Let's open with the orexin receptor, OX. The orexin receptor is a GPCR in the hypothalamus. This target is found in the brain, and so crossing the blood-brain barrier will be relevant to our discussion. The orexin receptor is named after its endogenous ligands, which are two neuropeptides, orexin A and orexin B. There are two forms of the orexin receptor. Form 1, OX1, is associated with stress and reward responses. Form 2, OX2, plays a role in wakefulness. Idorsia has a track record of working on orexin receptor ligands. The compound on this slide is called a dual orexin receptor antagonist, ADORA. The compound binds both OX1 and OX2 with nearly identical potency in the single-digit nanomolar range. The compound was explored for sleep disorders, which is an effect more associated with OX2 over OX1. Idorsia is not the only company developing orexin ligands. So the previously shown Idorsia compound is on the left, and two other orexin binders are on the right. What is different about these two other compounds is that they are selective for OX1 over OX2. So these are selective orexin-1 receptor antagonists. Recall that orexin-1 is tied to stress and reward responses, and the two compounds on the right have been explored for issues, including binge eating, substance abuse, and anxiety. While exploring the SAR around the scaffold of their dual orexin antagonist in the upper right, the scientists at Idorsia found a number of analogs with moderate selectivity for OX1. All these analogs involve changes to the aromatic ring on the left side of the structure. So the parent compound that we've seen before has very low selectivity. These other compounds have modest to good selectivity from about 2 to 1 with this oxidiazole to 20 to 1 in the pyrazole. With these compounds, Idorsia initiated a campaign to design an orally available selective orexin-1 receptor antagonist. Let's move ahead with this triazole 2-ethyl isomer, which is the most potent compound on this slide in terms of orexin-1, with an IC50 of just 0.8 nanomolar. The previous slide focused on the aromatic ring on the left. We're now looking at SAR for our ring system on the right, so this R group here. The first example in this table corresponds to the R group from the most potent OX1 compound from the previous slide. This compound has about a 4.5 to 1 selectivity. The other compounds here are not remarkably better, but the MedChem team like this compound in the bottom left. The OX1 potency is just a bit better. The OX2 potency is just a bit worse. The selectivity is somewhat better at 10 to 1. Coincidentally, the part of the optimal R group on the right of the molecule also includes a triazole 2-ethyl ring. This ring system is not nearly as frequently encountered as many other heterocyclic systems, and having two of them in a structure stands out, at least to me. Note that these compounds all have a 5-membered ring holding the parts of the structure together. This is a pyrrolidine ring. We'll look at changes to this ring on the next slide, with focus moving to the ADME properties of the compound and related members of the series. All right, note that in the upper right, the central ring is now a six-membered ring. The first entry in the table, however, is the five-membered ring, the pyrrolidine, from the previous slide. We can see that the compound has its 10:1 OX1 to OX2 selectivity. Note that the previous structure is quite quickly metabolized in stability assays with both rat and human liver microsomes. Inhibition of cytochrome 3A4 with an IC50 of around 3 micromolar is also a concern. Inhibition of CYP3A4 indicates a very high risk of drug-drug interactions. Expanding the ring with different groups, CH2, NH, and oxygen, improved metabolic stability, at least with human microsomes, and reduced 3A4 inhibition. This bottom compound, that is compound 17 in the paper, became the primary lead with a slight loss in potency relative to the pyrrolidine, but much improved predicted human metabolic stability and much weaker 3A4 inhibition. At this point, the chemistry team looked into refining the substitution pattern on the aromatic ring in the upper right of the structure. Many new analogs were studied at this stage. I'm only showing four, and all of these are different methylated isomers. The best compound from the previous slide is the 5-methyl isomer. That was compound 17. Of the other methylated isomers, the 4-methyl compound, 20 in the paper, had similar activity, a bit better selectivity, and a bit lower metabolic stability. Both compounds were among the most promising leads going forward. Note that the chemistry team also looked at additional substituents on the left aromatic ring. Let's now look at three of the top compounds across these series. Let's talk about the brain exposure of these compounds. Keep in mind that orexin receptors are found in the hypothalamus, so distribution into the brain is vital for efficacy. This table lists three compounds. Let's look at the columns. We have on-target potency, the unbound plasma concentration, this is in rats, the unbound concentration in brain tissue, the ratio of unbound brain to plasma concentration, and the estimated occupancy of the orexin-1 receptor. The first row is our original 5-methyl isomer on the right side ring and has no additional substitution on the left side, compound 17. When looking at these compounds, we can see that the top compound has relatively poor exposures in the plasma and brain. This is explained by poor solubility of the top compound. Furthermore, based on the brain to plasma ratio, the top compound seems to favor the plasma, which might be related to being an efflux transporter substrate. These data strongly disfavor the top compound. The bottom two compounds, which only differ by a fluorine atom on the left side ring, are fairly similar, though potency and exposures do somewhat favor the middle compound. With this information, the bottom two compounds, numbers 20 and 35, respectively, were advanced into an in vivo efficacy study. So here are some in vivo efficacy data. The animal disease model was schedule-induced polydipsia, SIP, in rats. Polydipsia is excessive thirst, so rats can be conditioned to display symptoms of polydipsia by controlling their feeding schedule. The resulting polydipsia can then be used as a model for obsessive compulsive behavior. The premise is that animals with reduced water intake, this column, may correlate with antagonism of the orexin-1 receptor, which is associated with stress and reward responses. The last column shows animal activity, which is a potential surrogate for orexin-2 receptor antagonism, which is associated with wakefulness and the sleep cycle. So with compound 20, in a dose-dependent manner, water intake was reduced. At the highest dose, water intake reduction was statistically significant relative to the vehicle group. While activity level reduced somewhat, the reduction was not statistically significant to a p-value of 0.05. Similar results were observed for compound 35. These data collectively could be interpreted as 1. Evidence of antagonism on the orexin-1 receptor, and 2. Evidence of selectivity for OX1 over OX2. Both compounds were encouraging, but the top compound, compound 20, was ultimately selected for clinical study based on solubility and ease of synthesis. Therefore, compound 20, with a research designation of ACT-539313, was advanced into clinical trials. The compound showed good on-target potency, promising blood-brain barrier penetration, high OX1 to OX2 selectivity, good solubility, low activity in various safety panels for off-target activity, and low predicted human clearance of 1.1 milliliters per minute per kilogram of patient mass. ACT-539313, now under the registered name of Nivasorexant, completed Phase 1 trials for safety and tolerability. The compound has also advanced into Phase 2 trials for use in binge eating disorders. Nivasorexant, unfortunately, did not meet its primary endpoint in the study. While I do not know the particular details of this study, I think Nivasorexant is perhaps representative of the challenge of treating behavioral disorders. Animal models for behavioral disorders can be very difficult to design and reliably provide predictions of drug activity in humans. According to the paper, the drug program is currently under evaluation at Idorsia. Thank you for watching to the end of this drug discovery story on Nivasorexant, a selective orexin-1 receptor antagonist. A link to the original JMedChem article is in the video description. Please consider subscribing to the channel, leaving a like, or making a comment. Take care.